In this video, we are going to talk about SAP Integration Content Catalog. SAP provides prepackaged content for developers to implement integrations quickly. By using this prepackaged content, you can build integrations out of the box. This prepackaged content is provided by SAP or third-party providers. When you are working with Integration Catalog, you need to remember three different roles. One is Integration Developer, Content Publisher, Content Reviewer. As an integration developer, you try to use the integration content to build end-to-end integrations. Content Publisher actually creates integration content and publishes into the integration catalog. Content Reviewer is a person who reviews the quality of the integration content. You can have two different types of integration content. One is configure only, which means you can configure existing content and you cannot modify the integration content. The second type is content edit, where you can edit the content and modify according to your needs. As an integration developer, when you are planning to consume prepackaged integration content in SAP CPI, you need to follow four different types of steps. One is search the integration catalog, import the integration content, configure or modify the integration content, deploy the integration content. In the following video, I will show you how you can work with SAP Integration Catalog. Let's begin. Let me now walk you through SAP Integration Catalog in SAP CPI. So go to Discover, Integrations. And now this is the Integration Catalog where you can see all the integration content. So at the moment we have 538 items. And you can actually use different filters, for example, platforms, vendors, line of business, industries, products, and countries. For example, I will now choose Netherlands. Okay. So now I have this NL, Netherlands Electronic VAT written content. So it will open the content for you. So here you can find different types of information. For example, you can see the description of the content, what is the purpose of the content, and when it is created, and what are the different artifacts. And you see the type. We can have different types of integration content, for example, value mapping or integration flow and so on. And you can see the corresponding documentation there. And tags for the content, as well as rating here. And you see here the vendor is from SAP and the mode is editable, which means you can actually edit this integration content. So now let's go to the artifacts and see whatever you're looking for is there, for example, the integration content. So open it and see the integration flow. So after the validation and you wanted to use this integration content, then go back and then click on the copy. Basically, that copies this integration content from integration catalog of SAP to your local repository. So now the package is copied. Go back to design part and integrations. There you can see the integration content that you just copied, and now it is editable. Open this integration content. Go to the artifacts and open the relevant integration content and do all the modifications that you want to do. So it's saying that if you edit, you cannot have automatic updates. That's fine. Edit. After you do all the modifications in this integration flow, then so you can do the changes here. Okay, there are two options for you after the modification. So basically you can actually save or save as a version. So with the save as a version, actually you can create your own version here, but for now what I do is just save and deploy. And you can deploy this now here. So now deploy. So basically this is now available at the runtime. So let's now go back to integrations, and here again to the same content that I just imported. So if you go to the artifacts, so actually I just want to show you, you can actually download this content and you can actually use it in SAP PO or CPI integrations. So it actually downloads a local folder. Then you can import this in the SAP PO integrations if you want to use it. So if you want to revert the version, you see, click on this version and you can actually go back to the previous versions. So click on the version again, and now you see the latest modified version and the old version. If you want to revert the change, click on this go back to the version, then it actually takes you to the previous version. So the switching of the version is quite easy here in the integration content. So here when I try to configure, there's nothing to configure in this integration content. So what I do is, I'll show an example how you can actually do the configuration. Let's open other integration content. This is SAP Customer Relationship Management with SAP Field Service Management. So if you go to the artifacts, because I just want to show you how you can configure only scenario. For example here, now select the artifact and here you see the configure. Basically, you can actually configure four different types of parameters: timer, sender, receiver, and all the exposed strings for the integration content. So you enter the fields here. Basically, you can configure it and you can use the integration content as it is. So these are the configurable fields in the integration content. So now after modification, you can save and then deploy. So now let's deploy it. Let's close it now for now. That's it about SAP Integration Content Catalog. Hope you learn how to configure, how to edit integration content. I will see you in the next session.